Good control of blood sugar is very important to prevent the complications. So that is of utmost importance. By exercise, by food, by drugs, all are important. To keep the blood pressure within normal limits, say below 130 by 80 mm of mercury. To keep the cholesterol and triglycerides within normal limits at the lower side is not very difficult. And no smoking. It's very important that the patient should not chew tobacco or smoke cigarettes or beers, because it's almost respectful in the young individuals and also in other groups. So by practicing good habits, we can prevent the complications of diabetes. It's very important to keep the blood sugar under control. This is the single most important factor. Besides that, the high blood pressure, the high blood cholesterol should be kept in check, and also no smoking and no use of any tobacco products. Besides, regular check up of the different systems like eye, foot, kidneys, etc. are very much required. Also, evaluation of the heart, because diabetes is a coronary artery disease equivalent. And this can trigger a lot of complications, and the diabetic patient should daily inspect the legs in order to see whether there is any sore, ulceration or fissuring, especially in between the fingers. And if it occurs, we should treat ourselves by own self, and we should go to the doctor and immediately consult him, because immediate consultation with the doctor can prevent many of the complications. About the lifestyle modification measures, it's very important to increase the telomere length or longevity in a patient with diabetes mellitus if proper lifestyle is maintained. Number one, to keep the proper body weight, one should gain weight. Rather, if he is obese, he should lose weight, and this is very important. Diet is also very important. One should take a lot of fruits, fresh vegetables, and nuts, legumes, peas, etc. Especially almonds, peanuts, and walnuts. These are called as tree nuts. These are all very important. And also to keep the weight is very important. One should gain weight, and if somebody is obese, he should lose it. And regular exercise in the form of 4 to 5 kilometers of brisk walking, or jogging, or swimming, or playing some sort of tennis or table tennis or badminton also is very helpful in keeping one fit. And in between, somebody can go for fasting. Recently, there's been a lot of emphasis on intermittent fasting, and it has been found that it activates the hypoactive pancreatic beta cells and does rejuvenate the pancreas. So intermittent fasting is being incorporated as a treatment of choice in these diabetic patients. Regarding the familial incidence or genetic incidence of diabetes mellitus, it is true that type 1 and type 2 diabetes mellitus both are sometimes found in the families. Suppose any of the parents or the grandparents have diabetes, or the maternal uncle, and it is seen that the patient has developed diabetes in younger age. However, if we practice good lifestyle measures, we can prevent the onset of diabetes mellitus, or we can cure it even if it is present. So strict dieting, regular walking, and also regular screening. And screening for other organs as well. Like diabetes is a coronary artery disease. So if we regularly, at least once in a year, we have a eye examination, the urine examination, especially who are pre-diabetics or diabetics, we can prevent many of the complications. The nephropathy can be detected. Urinary ACR should be estimated at least once a year, and regular eye examination, regular foot examination, regular heart examination, one ECG, one echocardiogram, and one TMT, that is exercise stress test, is very important to exclude any diabetic coronary artery disease or target organ damage. So especially in families where it goes, we should have an intermittent checkup, and not only of blood sugar but also of hemoglobin A1C, to see what was the blood sugar during the last 3 months. So it's very essential to keep the patients home. Sometimes this gestational diabetes continues in future life also, and there is increase of blood sugar in this population, but it is also found in elderly ladies, and it is very difficult. The prognosis of patients with diabetes is worse in ladies than in youngs. You should remember, suppose the incidence of heart failure in ladies, diabetic ladies, is 3 to 4 times, whereas in males it is 2 to 3 times, because diabetic patients often do develop heart failure, and this is more common in lady patients. And what we observe, that the quality of care, the remission of the elevated blood sugar, etc., the level of hemoglobin A1C around is much worse in ladies in comparison to males, maybe because of some genetic bias or whatever we call it, or care of the society regarding the ladies as a whole. So it is a big problem, and they bear the children, so we should be particularly respectful to our mothers, to our wives, to our sisters, and we should look at their global health, not only diabetes, but also the exercise, they take good food, they are lean, thin, active, energetic, so that we can prevent onset of diabetes in this population. And especially during pregnancy, we should be very careful and under the guidance of a good diabetologist and gynecologist.